the extraordinary man who was Klemperer came onto the platform for the rehearsal at the Albert Hall, wild of eye, with his tie all awry and crooked and tall and gangling. And to my absolute amazement, he walked about in the middle of the orchestra while he was conducting the rehearsal, walked about among us, as it were, speaking to us with his face as we played, without any talking at all. I thought, well, this is a very, very extraordinary man. I was quite bowled over.
Beethoven's Eroica Symphony made up the second half of Klemperer's first Philharmonia concert at the Royal Albert Hall on the 5th of March 1948. Although by now his movements were sometimes shaky and even hampered by his physical condition, there was no question of his strong musical intention and, despite his infirmity, his powerful rhythmic control. His rugged and very granite-like performance of this work impressed some critics very considerably. However, the concert as a whole did not go down well with a lot of reviewers, and certainly what Walter Legg heard did not impress him. He, in any case, was not the promoter of the concert, and he left after the interval, thereby missing the Eroica Symphony. It was not until 3 years later, when Klemperer conducted as, in fact, a third choice for Legg, that there was a revelation. For Legg, the audience, and the critics. For one of the opening concerts of the Royal Festival Hall in May 1951, Klemperer ended his programme with Mozart's Jupiter Symphony. Legg only arrived in time to hear the last movement, and he was transfixed by its energy, power, and rhythmic precision. He was determined to offer Klemperer a contract for the future.
Thank you.
In fact, 3 more years were to elapse before Klemperer returned to the Philharmonia to start making recordings for EMI and giving concerts. Later in 1951, he slipped and fell after leaving a shop at Montreal Airport, and he crashed heavily to the ground, sustaining severe injuries that were to incapacitate him for a very long time. It took many months before he began to recover in any way at all, and then innumerable physical complications set in. He didn't conduct at all for well over a year, and he was taken over by a protracted period of severe depression. There were also other personal and additional legal issues that held him back from returning to London. But when finally he did come in 1954, a completely new era in his life began. It was with the music of Beethoven, in a concert devoted entirely to that composer's works, that he set his audience and the few critics who were there alight. Once again, it was the Eroica Symphony that made a particularly powerful impression. And it was this work that began one of the most celebrated projects in recording history the following year, as Klemperer embarked on recording the entire cycle of Beethoven symphonies with the Philharmonia Orchestra. His gestures were now much sparser and tempi slower than in earlier times, but the energy and rhythmic power were undiminished, as you'll hear at the start of the next disc.